Ladies and gentlemen, please stand now for the posting of the colors by the Metropolitan Police Department's Honor Guard, and please remain standing for the singing of the National Anthem by Police Officer John Leggett and tonight's invocation by Police Chaplain Willie James.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we've hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we've watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the
Please be seated. Now we'll have the invocation by Police Chaplain Willie James.
Eternal God, we thank you for these men and women who have chosen a career in law enforcement, and their family members and friends that support them. We also thank you for all who have helped them through the past weeks to prepare them for a successful profession. Thank you for the mayor, the chief of police, public service supervisors, the academy staff, and trainers, and all who have helped to make the Metropolitan Police Department the finest in this country. Tonight, as each one comes forward to receive their badge, we recommend them to you and pray your blessings upon them for having a desire to make our community a safe one to live in. We realize that it takes a unique person with character that is strong to survive this profession. With your help, O God, they will be able to perform their job with dignity, honesty, and integrity. We pray now that you will surround them with your divine protection and be always in your care. It's in your name, O God, we pray. Amen.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Melanie Moon with the KPLR 11 and Fox 2. Welcome to the graduation ceremony for Recruit Class 2015-01. I am just so honored to be back here again to be mistress of ceremony for such an amazing and important event. We are so very thrilled that you all are with us for this very important ceremony, recognizing these 17 young women and men who have chosen to serve our community. They have spent 30 weeks of training in the classrooms, in the firearms range, and in the gym to get ready to become St. Louis police officers. The department's police academy prepared them for one of the most noble and unselfish professions that exist, a career in law enforcement. Please now allow me to introduce you to these men seated to my left on the platform tonight. I ask that you please hold your applause until everyone has been introduced. First, the Honorable Francis G. Slay, Mayor of the City of St. Louis. Next, Colonel Sam Dotson, Commissioner, Chief of Police. Lieutenant Colonel Gerard Leshock, Bureau of Enforcement. Lieutenant Colonel Ronnie Robinson, Bureau of Community Relations, Organizational Department. Mayor Rochelle D. Jones, the Bureau of Operations Commander. Sergeant Angela Taylor, Director of the St. Louis Police Academy. Police Chaplain Willie James, who delivered our invocation this evening. And I also want to acknowledge the commanders seated in the audience over here to my left. These are the men and women who will help guide these new officers during their careers with the St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department. Welcome, everyone, and thank you so much for taking part in tonight's ceremony. Please give them all a big round of applause. And now to offer congratulations to these young men and women, Mayor Francis Slay.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. It is indeed an honor for me to stand before these brave men and women who today dedicate their lives to public service. Ladies and gentlemen, you are looking at a new generation of St. Louis police officers. The men and women who are graduating this evening have met and surpassed the high standards of our outstanding police academy. They are continuing one of the greatest traditions in American law enforcement, and we're very proud of them. And they will bear the new standard of a department that is now an agency of the city they serve. The jobs that they are asked to do are as difficult today as ever. It takes a very special person, a strong, compassionate person, someone with a deep commitment to our community and with a heart to serve others, to put on that vest and that badge every single day. Many of the people you will encounter will not want to see you. You will be holding them accountable. You will be protecting the public from their crimes. But know this, the city stands behind you and supports you. There are far, far more people in our city who will praise you, who will commend you, and who will thank you for your service, even if they don't use the opportunity to tell you. If you do your job honestly, faithfully, and morally, you will succeed. Of course, you must be fair, you must be just. The eyes of the world are watching you now more than ever. Police officers are also the backbone of our economic growth. People come to St. Louis, live in our city, spend money here, work here when they feel safe and when they are safe. New officers will help make that a reality for hundreds of thousands of residents and visitors every single day. With teamwork, we will protect this city together. It is a teamwork in city government, and we do work as a team. We will help keep people safe. We will continue to make crime go down. Together, you will help protect each other. You can prevent crime, make a difference, and bring justice to crime victims. And may God bless you for that. You have not chosen a job, but you've chosen a career. It takes a special person to be a police officer. You take an oath to put other people before yourselves. It is indeed a selfless act, and our city thanks you for that. I know from Chief Dotson what an outstanding class this is, and how each of the graduates is up to the challenge, and I congratulate you. To Chief Dotson, the command and academy staff, thank you for the investment you have made in these officers. To the commanders and supervisors to whom the class have been assigned, please watch over these young officers, help them to become as good as you are. To the families and friends of these officers, thank you for guiding these officers to a career in service. Thank you for the support you've given them so far, and I know you know they're going to need your support even more in the future. Please know that we treasure them as much as you do, and they will constantly be in our thoughts and our prayers, and will have our support. Represent your city well. I know you will.
Thank you, Mayor Slay. Now I'd like to invite to the podium Commissioner Sam Dotson. He has some words for our graduates.
Well, good evening, and thank you for being here. And I do have words for our graduates, for our recruits. But I want to start with the families and the friends that are here to support our new police officers tonight. They've spent the last 6 months learning what it means to be part of a police family. And tonight is really your first indoctrination, your first chance to see what it means to be part of a police family. The men and women that are graduating tonight, as the mayor said, have some very daunting tasks in front of them. And they made these choices to be police officers. They made their decisions, but they couldn't have done it without the support of the family. And so I ask one thing, that every day when these officers leave, whether you're a mother, a father, a brother, a sister, a husband or a wife, a significant other, to look at them and pat them on the back and say, have a good day, honey. Enjoy your job today. Because they are going to face some of the biggest challenges of any profession that I can think of. But I will tell you, in the 21 plus years that I've been doing this job, there hasn't been a day that I haven't been satisfied and said, I made the absolute right career choice for me. And these young people are going to have that same experience every day of their career. And to the recruits, you're 17, but you're a mighty 17. You filled this auditorium pretty well. And that shows that you have people that care about you and people that support you. And never lose sight of that. Those are the people that are important. Your support network are the people that you need to take care of. They will take care of you, and you need to take care of them. So I went to visit the recruits today at the academy, and they were all a little anxious. We were talking about their assignments and where their first district was going to be, which is a big deal. It's a big deal to know where that you're going. But we kind of had two conversations. All right, I told them we were going to have two conversations. The first one was the tough love conversation that I think any proud parent, and I feel like a proud parent to you, any proud parent is going to have, to talk about your moral compass, to be true to yourself, to know that you're going to face some very serious headwinds as soon as you start in your new assignment. But at the end of the day, you have to be able to look at yourself in the mirror and know that you've done the right thing. I call police work the noblest of professions because it is. And so I have complete confidence that you're going to do that. You're going to go to work every day with a strong moral compass and face the challenges that you have. But I want to do the other side of it too now. And as the mayor said, there are far more people in our community that support you, that respect you, that love the job that you do and want you to do more of it. So this year earlier, and I've read this letter before, I wanted to read a letter to you because this sums up how the community looks at us and how you should look at yourself. So I received this letter out of the blue on April 5th of this year. And it starts out, Dear Chief Dotson, I'm almost 90 years old and in pretty good health, except that I don't sleep through the night. And on March 24th at 2 a.m., I got up after tossing and turning and sat in a chair by the living room window. All of a sudden, I saw red and blue lights flashing. I saw two police cars and two police vans. The police had pulled over and had a driver park at the curb across the street from my house. It was very quiet. There were no sirens, just lights. Four police officers were in the street. One was taking the man in that they had pulled over. After a little while, the man who parked his car got out, and the police officers handcuffed him and put him in the back of the police car. I am relating this story to you because at least four of our city's police officers put their lives on the line that night. They could have been they could have been shot or hurt, and none of us neighbors would have ever known what happened. The presence in our neighborhood made us feel safer, and as one grateful citizen, I want to say thank you to you and your officers who risk your life every night to keep us safe. That's why we do the job. So this 90-year-old woman can sit in her house in the middle of the night and feel safe. So you have my utmost respect, you have my utmost belief that you are going to represent the Metropolitan Police Department in the finest fashion and tradition as those have come before you. So congratulations and thank you.
I live in the city of St. Louis, and I can tell you I sleep a lot better knowing that we have such a fine and strong police force in St. Louis. So thank you, new recruits, for making me sleep better every night. It is time now to present these new officers with their badges and their certificates. Commissioner Dotson, with the assistance of Lieutenant Colonel Leshek, will issue these badges. Class Supervisor Police Officer Danelle L. Walters will announce the new officers as he approaches the podium. I ask that the platform guests please stand.
Officer Erica Anderson. Officer Michael Dom. Officer Justin Davis. Officer Richard Eves. Officer Michael Hines. Woo! Officer Zohaib Khan. Officer Jeremiah Coper. Officer Wesley McCormick. Officer Christopher Myers. Officer Michael O'Callaghan. Officer Sheila Phillips. Officer Amar Razul. Officer Tanya Rodman. Officer Ronald Russ. Officer Andrew Schmick. Officer Jasmine Spivey. Officer Terrence Williams.
You're going to see in the police department we do a lot of stand up and sit down. So I'm going to ask all the recruits to stand up so we can administer the oath of office. They got the jewelry, now the important part. So if you'd raise your right hand, please, and repeat after me. I solemnly swear, that I'm a citizen of the United States, and the state of Missouri, that I will faithfully support the Constitution of the United States, and of the state of Missouri, that I will, to the best of my skill and ability, diligently and faithfully, without partiality or prejudice, discharge my duties as a police officer, according to the laws of the state of Missouri, and the ordinances of the city of St. Louis, that I will strictly obey all lawful rules and orders of the St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department, the Chief of Police, or any officer placed by them over me, that I will not cease to perform my duties as a police officer until discharged, or until my resignation is accepted by the Chief of Police. So help me God. Congratulations.
You guys can stand if you want to. Good job to the family and friends for your enthusiasm and for coming out to support your loved ones. Very good crowd tonight. To our new officers, I ask that you please stand and turn around now. Face the audience. Isn't this a fine group of officers? Go ahead and give them another round of applause. They've worked hard. Now it is time to recognize several of these officers for their individual achievements. To say a few words on behalf of the Academy and to present the special awards is their class supervisor, Donnell Walters.
Good evening. Let me begin by offering a special thanks to the Honorable Mayor Francis Slay, Commissioner Chief Sam Dotson, commanding officers, distinguished guests, friends and families of Recruit Class 2015-01. Thank you for celebrating with these new officers. As I stand in front of you this evening, I get the wonderful opportunity to recognize the officers of this class that excelled during their training and whose performances warrant special recognition. Although everyone in this class worked hard, some stood out. Before I do so, I would like to congratulate the entire class for a special achievement. On April 6, 2015, they entered the St. Louis Police Academy as recruits. Tonight, they graduate and become part of the elite St. Louis Metropolitan Police Officers. By doing so, this shows how they combined all their individual skills and knowledge to complete the task at hand, which I'm sure they will use as they begin their careers as a police officer. Now I would like to acknowledge the following officers for their individual achievements. Officer Tanya Rodman, please stand. Our first award this evening goes to the individual who best represents core values of leadership, integrity, service, and fair treatment to all. To win the Core Value Award, a recruit looks beyond individual success by stepping forward into the role of leader. He or she must show flawless character along with a strong sense of justice. In the eyes of the Academy staff, there can be no question that that person is Officer Rodman. Congratulations, Officer Rodman. You may be seated. Officer Andrew Smick, please stand and remain standing. The recruit academic training curriculum consists of a menu of disciplines in which every recruit is tested. The training includes constitutional law, criminal investigations, juvenile procedures, patrol, report writing, and traffic, to name a few. Each of the course exams has a possible grade total of 100 points. Officer Schmidt completed the academy with a final average of 95.88. He is receiving an award for his outstanding academic achievement. Congratulations, Officer Schmidt. Officer Michael Hines, please stand and remain standing. During a recruit's training, they are tested on proficiency with the firearm. Only one recruit earns the right to be called Top Gun. During training, each recruit must qualify with a 9mm Beretta on a course of fire that's from the 7, 15, and 25-yard lines. The course must be completed 3 times, attempting to score 300 points each time. The total possible score is 900. Officer Hines scored a perfect 900. He is the Top Gun. Congratulations, Officer Hines. Remain standing. Don't sit down. Stand back. During recruit training, the physical fitness program challenges recruits to push themselves to their physical limits. Officer Hines' participation in the physical training program was nothing short of outstanding. The final challenge for each recruit is the physical abilities test, which is conducted on the fitness center's obstacle course. The course consists of running a distance of approximately 220 yards, negotiating hurdles, a balance beam, jumping a 4-foot wall, and pulling a 150-pound dummy 50 feet. The maximum passing score is 3 minutes. Officer Hines completed the course in 1 minute and 59 seconds. Congratulations, Officer Hines. You may be seated. Officer Ronald Russ, please stand and remain standing. Officer Russ is receiving an award for his outstanding performance in defensive tactics. Each recruit completes over 70 hours of defensive tactics instruction, which requires them to participate in hand-to-hand combat drills, intermediate weapons training, and subject control techniques. Officer Russ received 100% on his written test and demonstrated superior proficiency in all phases of training. Congratulations, Officer Russ. Each of these officers excelled in one area of training. But now, let's take a look at one officer who excelled across the board, Officer Michael Hines. Please stand and remain standing. Using a formula that calculates each officer's academic average, physical training score, and firearm score, an overall average is reached. Officer Hines is receiving the award for the best overall officer for recruit class 2015-01. The recipient of this award must maintain high scores in all aspects of academy training. Congratulations, Officer Hines. Have a seat. In closing, class 2015-01, it has been an honor and a privilege to work with each of you during your training. This recognition reflects more than just your individual excellence. Think of it also as something more, an opportunity to better the lives of others in this department and in the city you serve. I wish you a safe and successful career. Congratulations on your graduation.
Now I believe Sam Dotson, Chief Dotson, is going to return to the podium. He has some final thoughts.
So one of the things that is always important is that this class, any class, identifies a leader in the class. And so they've chosen a recruit, Tanya Rodman, to be their spokesperson. And I think Officer Rodman now has some things that she'd like to add, and then I'd like to come back and talk about Officer Rodman for a minute.
Good evening. On behalf of Class 1501, I'd like to thank our class supervisor, Officer Donnell Walters, and class assistant supervisor, Officer Eva Millard Galvan, for their dedication, leadership, and constant professionalism. I'd like to thank Mayor Slay, Commissioner Dotson, and all the commanders of the St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department, whose presence serves as a reminder of the great responsibility we assume tonight. Most importantly, I'd like to thank the friends and the family members in the audience tonight. You have seen us through the past 30 weeks. Without your unwavering support, we would not be able to walk across the stage tonight. If I had to pick one word to describe our class, it would be diversity. The definition is a simple one. It is defined as people coming together from different races, nationalities, religions, and sexes to form a group, organization, or community, or in our case, a class. The definition may seem simple, but the results of diversity are not simple. They are complex. Diversity not only includes physical appearance, religious beliefs, and race, but opinions, thoughts, and past experiences that are different than our own. We learn from people that are different than ourselves, people who have different beliefs and perspectives. It helps us each to see the world through others' eyes. And it makes us better at the end of the day by breaking down barriers and building a bridge of trust and understanding. Early on, our class adopted the motto, "The most diverse class of first." This could not be more true. We are a diverse group that came together because we all have the same calling, to give back to the community and to make a difference in the city we all now call home. We have come together in this room from all different walks of life. Some of us grew up in the urban core, others the more rural upbringings. And what makes this class unique is that we have several different countries represented. We have Ireland, Afghanistan, and Pakistan. This is diversity. This is class 1501. Class 1501 is a class of first. We are Officer Walters' first class. We are the first post-Ferguson selected class. We are the first to receive a class on human trafficking, first to volunteer at Peace Fest, first to visit the federal courts building, and the first to present on the topic of implicit bias to the distinguished Captain Mary Edwards Fierce. We have learned a lot during our 30 weeks in the Police Academy. Of course, human behavior, patrol, and report writing, amongst many others, have helped us prepare for our next step in our career. However, what we've learned from each other as classmates, friends, and colleagues is just as important. Things like teamwork, trust, compassion, and most of all, respect. Each class pays respect to a St. Louis City police officer who has lost their life in the line of duty. Our class is honored to represent Officer Todd Merriweather. Officer Merriweather lost his life in the line of duty on September 11, 1994. He was only 27 years old. And he, like all of us graduating tonight, had the same calling, a desire to make a difference, to stand up for those who are not able, to make a difference in the community and protect and serve the community we love. We understand the commitment we are making by taking this oath tonight and walking across this stage to accept a St. Louis City police badge. We will no longer represent ourselves and our families. We represent all law enforcement across our nation. Our actions moving forward will reflect on every officer who has taken the oath before us, including Officer Todd Merriweather, who paid the ultimate sacrifice for our great city. We know that at the end of the day, everything depends on the quality and the character of each individual officer. We will not tarnish the badge. We vow not to forget what we have learned the past 30 weeks: teamwork, trust, compassion, and respect. The most diverse class of first, congratulations on a job well done. Thank you.
So I was very careful not to do this before Officer Rodman spoke. When we talk about family, they're just not hollow words. They really are who we are. So Officer Rodman was in Bethesda, Maryland this weekend with a brother who was struggling with cancer and has been for the past several months. He lost his battle yesterday, and Officer Rodman insisted to be here with her class and with us to recognize this accomplishment. Her family's with her brother. We are your family, and we're glad you're here with us.
Lovely speech. And we congratulate you, Tanya, Officer Tanya Rodman, on your leadership role with this class of 2015-01. I want to thank each of these new officers for their commitment to serving our community. Because of you, all of you, St. Louis is a safer and a better place to live and visit tonight. We are so proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, again, let's have a big round of applause to the newest members of the St. Louis Metropolitan Police Department. Don't you guys ever forget, or let anyone let you forget, that you are our city's finest. Thank you all so much, all of you, for joining us tonight to celebrate this exciting growth of our police force. And special thanks to the good people here at Harris Stowe State University for allowing us to use their beautiful facilities. I want to remind everyone to join us for a reception following the ceremony. It will be at the Freeman Bosley Jr. Dining Facility. I now ask Chaplain James to give a benediction. Please stand and remain standing as the Metropolitan Police Department's Honor Guard retires the colors.
Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen.
As the platform guests exit the stage, I ask that the audience please be seated. As Police Officer Darnell Walters dismisses Recruit Class 2015-01 for the very last time, have a great night and everyone drive carefully.